Wet Nose Animal Aid have brought my attention to a horrendous state of affairs in Romania, an EU state whose response to their street dog problem is to actively encourage their population to attack, maim or beat to a pulp any animals they come across. Not only is this incredibly cruel, counterproductive and short-sighted, but also fundamentally against the law in the EU. Wet Nose needs your help. I totally support them and hope you will too. Please help by donating or supporting them in whatever way you can. Thank you so much.
You didn't come. What have I done to make you leave me all alone?
Wet Nose Animal Aid with the Norton Animal Rescue and the Canine Angels, myself, Saffron Republica and Lorraine Chase are out here to highlight the problem of stray dogs in the last few years. Some that have been beaten and been shot, been run over on purpose, been tortured, faces have been destroyed by people attacking them with metal bars.
There's a feeling that the government in some way is making money out of the situation and So keeping it going. And though we've discovered, yes, there's a lot of truth in these stories, this isn't the land of the cruel. There are some wonderful people doing stalwart work, many out of their own pockets, all of them with their hearts.
Yes.
And it's
wonderful, and they should be supported. The animal rescue shelters here should be supported by the government, as they are doing a wonderful job. And we hope that our trip here will help to raise awareness
and
highlight what's happening and gain support in the UK and beyond.
There is no EU directive in Europe regarding stray dog management. The EU's view is that each member state has responsibility for dealing with the matter itself, and this laissez-faire stance has resulted in a dreadful state for strays in many EU countries. This Wet Nose documentary aims to dispel some of the confusion regarding the stray dog situation in Romania, and a team went out to Bucharest in 2014 to establish what was actually happening there. It found that local taxes were being raised ostensibly to resolve the problem, but in reality, the government agencies ASPA and ANSVA were dealing with it in the most barbaric way and deliberately creating a self-sustaining situation, a business opportunity, which continues to generate huge sums of money from the misery inflicted upon these poor animals.
I'm the joint founder of Wet Nose Animal Aid, and we are here in Bucharest on an overcast day, and we have grouped around the table. We have representatives from Canine Angels. We have Lorraine, bless her heart, who's here. Gary from Norton Animal Rescue. And last but no mean least, we've got Saffron, who is a wonderful singer. There is a huge stray dog problem in Romania. Massive, massive problem. It's compounded by the fact that an awful lot of Romanian people consider them as vermin and not as companion dogs. And the Romanian authorities, frankly, don't seem to care very much. A lot of these dogs, and there are probably other animals as well, are dispatched in the most horrible way. They're put into so-called kennels and centres, which are something akin to the Holocaust in the last war. Things have got really, really, really bad. We are making a documentary, and hopefully that will help people on the ground and people who are looking in to get people interested and focused and try and in some way to alleviate it. Tomorrow we're going to two places where, has already been said about Mowland, then we're going to Footprints of Joy, and then on the Sunday we're just going here locally, relatively locally, to Red Panda, and we're also meeting a vet called Aurelian. He is doing good work and we've got questions for him as well. And then in the afternoon we're going to be taken and shown to places loosely in this area. Possibly we'll go to the shelter of no name, the pre-Brigadier place where the 90 dogs were taken from. So that's what the plot is.
When the plight of Romanian dogs first came to light, it was suggested that the government was actively or indirectly encouraging the public to cull dogs by any means available. Wetnose started its inquiries by talking to Dr. Carmen Arsene and Filippo Agostino from Save the Dogs and asking what the law says about this.
In Romania, it is prohibited for many years to kill an animal by citizens. An animal could be killed only by a vet and for certain reasons. Till September, it was prohibited to kill a healthy stray dog. There are citizens that mistreat animals, but up to now, nobody was fined.
One of the main problems with this new law in Romania was that the message given to the population was that it was, in a way, possible to kill dogs. So the reaction of people was, of course, very stupid, because in Romania there are very good laws of protection of animals, but with the new law about euthanasia, about killing dogs after 14 days that they enter in a public or private shelter, of course this was a bad message to population. Population understood that it was in a way possible to kill dogs also on the street, and in the last months, of course, a lot of dogs were poisoned by people, were captured in a bad way by people, were killed by people. Of course, this was a bad message to population. The message that should came from the state of Romania should be only of a message of protection of all animals here in Romania, especially for dogs.
In Romania, hundreds of thousands of dogs have been killed with no result in the streets. The density of canine population increased with the rate of killing. The authorities did not like to approve other kind of method, like, for example, sterilization and return. And a recommendation given by OMS from Geneva, where the experts drowned some conclusions at the fact that the stray dog management has to be done only by sterilization and not by killing.
With the new law, things changed. We focus more and more on own animals, yard animals,
yeah.
Backyard dogs,
yeah.
Poor people's animals, you know, so that we stop the flow of animals into the street, because
mm-hmm.
obviously those animals come from somewhere, and mm-hmm. the main source is owned animals. That's the main problem.
Really, they don't want to spay their own dogs.
Yes, they don't want to spay their own dogs. They have a litter, then they put it in a bag and they bring it to the market. Well, they will find a way in life. Mm. Well, not that doesn't.
I don't understand that, because the simplest way to eradicate this problem is basically spaying. And I don't understand that people are not understanding that.
Yes, but the problem is they think that spaying is something unnatural against God.
Oh, really?
Or something. So most of the work is with people's minds.
Yes,
you know, there's some sort of blockage, mm. very high in the government. Mm. You know, they don't understand how things work, in my opinion. So then they don't listen.
Yeah,
there should be a plan. There should be a plan how to address this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what the main issues are: people mentality, mm-hmm. spay neuter, education,
yeah.
right? Adoptions, of course.
Yes.
But adoptions, mm-hmm. unfortunately, whilst they change the future for that one particular animal.
Absolutely, I'm with you 100%.
Cannot change the base of the problem. I strongly believe that private help from abroad is essential.
Yes.
In boosting Romanian animal welfare.
Mm-hmm.
The state does very little. Very little, and not in the good way.
Fear for Autumn, it's working since last year. We were working with the authorities since 10 years. We offer to castrate the dogs on our money, on the donors' money.
Yes.
They don't want. They don't want, because they told me, are you stupid? Do you want to solve the problem? Yes, I want to solve
yes,
the problem.
Yes, of course.
I care about them. Oh, surprise. But they don't want to do that.
With the new law in Romania, of course, for association as Save the Dogs, the daily work is more complicated, because We were using the international technique of trap, neuter and release dogs. But now, with this new law, this is not more possible. And so also, the number of dog captures are less than in the past. What's important in Romania, it's of course that we must now concentrate more than ever on dogs with owners, sterilizing each dog that has an owner.
The owners are obliged to castrate their dogs, but the term is to the end of this year. First, it is impossible practically, taking into consideration we have in Romania about 6 million of own dogs. It is almost impossible to castrate so many dogs in only 10 months.
We asked Dr. Arsene why she thought the Romanian authorities continue to support a policy of mass killing despite all these compelling studies and arguments, and despite the methods adopted being inefficient, much more expensive, immoral, and in contravention of EU legislation. Her answer was both clear and shocking.
Their interest is to keep a constant stray dog population in the street, such as to have possibility, a reason to allocate local budgets for stray dog management.
All the mayors are involved in this business, and dogs in the street means money.
Yes.
End of story. Yes. No?
Yes.
It's a huge business. They don't want to solve the problem, because as long as you solve the problem, as long as you don't have streets, dogs in the streets, you don't have any more the reason to invent budgets.
Yes. For example, in Bucharest, only for capturing a dog, the city hall pays about 50 euro to some companies that actually do not have any connection with stray dog management, building company, stomatology company, or design company. And this situation is only an example in Bucharest. On the other hand, inside the shelter, about 150 to 200 euro are used for used fictively for the dogs. The Romanian legislation says that it is compulsory. The public shelters have a vet, a veterinary technician. The dogs have to be checked every day from medical point of view. There is a stipulated condition for capturing that have to be human, and they are very explicitly there. Also, the condition for accommodation. How they have to be separated depending on the size of the dogs, depending on the age, the risk of aggressivity. They have to be fed twice per day, the adults, three per day, the puppies, and everything that it's actually normal. Something very fresh has happened in Bucharest, where the public service for stray dog management entered by force in a private shelter, destroyed the fences and the doors there, and took about 90 dogs. They captured the dogs even they were filmed. They captured the dogs in a cruel way. Eight of dogs died during the capturing. Some of them were not found anymore in their dog shelter.
He was stealing our dogs. All the dogs were under the key. Yes. They were under treatment. They were under contract. Yes. It was a private clinic, yes. And he came with 13 cars. He really, I don't know the name in English, Marcel.
Massacre.
35 dog catchers. Then he has the he's coming to TV and telling to us that only one dog suffered temporarily. Are we stupid? When we have the footage,
yes.
I mean, and I sent him an open question. Yes. Can you please let me know which one of these dogs suffered temporarily?
Yes.
When I see almost eight dead dogs, which one suffered temporarily? These are the dogs that they were still by us on Friday, 21 of March. And imagine that they took the these small puppies, very friendly, they took them with the stick, you know? So how can you do that? I mean, why? And these dogs were under the key.
You ready?
So they destroyed the key, three key they had. Three lock, you know?
Yep.
All of them they destroyed, and they took them. One of them we cannot find him. It's dead, or I don't know.
Maybe I can suppose that it was, let's say, a revenge. Also, because every dog, every capturing of dog is paid with 50 euro, it was a lot of money. It was very easy to capture some dogs that are closed in a shelter. Because they would like to do this also with other shelter, by the way. A list, a blacklist, appeared to be drafted by this public service, where 26 NGOs and about 30 people do not have the right to adopt dogs because, as they mentioned, the dogs adopted by them were abandoned in the street. It is really incredible how much lies they say to the people, and they would like to manipulate the masses from psychologically point of view, and this manipulation started from September 2, when the case with the boy was, and it was a national hysteria created by mass media.
Who is saying that dogs are aggressive? It's a huge lie, because I'm working with dogs since 15 years in Romania. Nobody attacked me, never. 2 weeks ago, a very drunk person, homeless, died. She died because of the
alcohol.
Yes. And they come, a poor homeless lady was killed by stray dogs.
Yes. No.
And in the same time, the judge said she died because of alcohol. Why do you continue to say something like that?
Just
of course, the ball
scandal
was, yes, the scandal start being. And after 1 day or 2 days, they come to our shelter and they destroy everything.
We made a lot of complaints. Even we have criminal cases. We arrived with these cases as a prosecutors. We arrived first, the first step is to make complaint to veterinary sanitary directions. But it is something very illogical. Their responses are always the same. We checked the situation and everything is according to the law.
Since the making of this documentary, two UK NGOs, Paws to Rescue and Lawyers for Animals, have taken the Romanian authorities to court. The Romanian anti-corruption authorities are investigating ASPA on the grounds of embezzlement, fraud and abuse of power, amongst other allegations. The Bucharest Court of Appeal has also ruled in favour of the international animal welfare organisation Four Paws and suspended the application norms of the killing law. The killing law no longer has any applicable norms, and the capture and killing of stray dogs has no legal framework. Though welcome progress, street dogs in public shelters are still subject to gross neglect and are killed by direct and indirect means. Sadly, there is also evidence that ASPA's illegal activities have continued as they continue to round up dogs in the streets. Wet Nose Animal Aid's campaign for awareness and change continues.